Lesson 2. What are the multi-domain security management server components? In this lesson, we're going to break down the MDSM server into their individual components. The multi-domain security management server is a Checkpoint product. It's a Checkpoint brand. It's a solution for a large enterprise customer, for a large service provider. The MDSM is a software solution that has a few products and has a few components that you need to install and you need to configure. The MDSM solution is a big and multiplex solution. The MDSM can be installed and configured differently depending on customer's environment, depending on customer sizes, depending on customer needs. In some cases, you might want to install all the products and components in one system. And in some other cases, you might need to install some products and components on one system, and then install the other products and the other components on different systems, on different appliances. So what are these products and what are these components? In this lesson, we're going to break down the multi-domain security management server into their products, into their components, and discuss their various functions. The multi-domain management system software has two main products that you can install. The first product is the multi-domain server, what we call the MDS for short. The second product is the multi-domain log server, what we call the MDLS server. The MDS server, the multi-domain server, is the product that will house the security policies for multiple domains. On the other hand, the MDLS server, the multi-domain log server, is the product that will house the log servers for multi-domains. All MDSM environments, all multi-domain security management environments, need to have at least a minimum of one MDS server installation. In fact, in some customers' environments, it's possible that they only install the MDS server product, period, and everything will work on one system. In other customer environments, they might require to have both the MDS product installed and also the MDLS product installed, but on two separate systems. The MDS, the multi-domain server, is where we store the domains for each customer, for each region. As mentioned before, we can create up to 250 domains on one MDS server. We call the domains on the MDS server a DMS, a domain management server. Each DMS, each domain management server, acts exactly like a security management server for a specific customer, for a specific domain. Each DMS, domain management server, manages security policy, the security database, the security rules for a customer, for a domain. And so if we have three customers, we have three domains, which means that we need to have three domain management servers, three DMSs. One domain management server for each customer for each domain. Correspondingly, an MDS server and multi-domain log server will also house up to 250 log server domains. And each log server domain on the MDLS server is what we call a DLS, a domain log server. A multi-domain log server sole's function is to store the logs for all the security gateways from all the security domains. Even though the MDLS server contains all the logs, you need to have a specific DLS for each domain. A DLS is a domain log server that stores the logs for only specific domain. Each DLS server keeps logs separate and compartmentalized, only for a specific domain, and it stores them on a separate container and separate directories and folders for each individual domain. And so I think an example here might be helpful. Imagine here we have domain X, which is a customer environment that contains a few gateways, which is being managed by DMS X, domain management server X, which is stored on the MDS server, the multi-domain management server. The domain management server X on the MDS server, that multi-domain server, will manage domain X environments, its security policies, its security gateways, etc. And so DMS X contains the security policies, the security database that will manage and install the security rule base for the domain X security gateways. And the domain X security gateways will inspect the traffic and send the logs to the log server. In this case, the domain log server, the DLS X, the domain log server X, which is running on the MDLS server, the multi-domain log server. And so again, we have a few products and a few components that we need to install when we deploy an MDSM server, a multi-domain management server. Let's review. First, we have the MDS server, the multi-domain management server, which houses the DMSs, the domain management servers. And second, we have the MDLS server, the multi-domain log server that houses the DLSs, the domain log server. These are the two basic products and components to the Checkpoint MDSM security solution, the multi-domain security management solution. Also, there's a few other components that we need to make clear, such as the MDS is a server that houses the DMS, the domain management server, for each domain. But I also like to add or make one more distinction, is that the MDS server itself has its own partition on the MDS appliance. It's almost like a domain for the MDS server itself. The MDS server, that MDS container, it houses MDS properties and permissions for the MDS server. For example, the MDS container contains permissions of who can access the MDS server. It also stores information like how many DMS it holds, how many domains it manages, and which administrators have permission to each domain, and which security gateways each domain management server manages. I like to think that the MDS container stores all the important and relative information for the MDS server. It contains all domain properties for the whole MDS server, for the whole MDS appliance. I'll discuss this more in detail later in this course, but for now, just know that the MDS server that houses the MDS container, its folders and its properties, and it also stores all the DMS, the domain management servers, and data. And also these same attributes also applies to the MDLS server. MDLS is a server that houses the DLSs, and also has a main container, the MDLS container, that houses all the multi-domain log server data. I like to say that the MDLS server is the appliance that stores the MDLS container information, which in turn has information about what DLSs servers it has and which domains manage those DLSs. Still confused? Let's see if you can clarify this a little bit more with a few examples. Let's look at a few customer environments to see how they could configure a multi-domain security management server. Scenario number one. In this scenario, imagine a small customer environment or a small service provider, and here we have just one MDSM appliance. And if we have only one appliance, then we'll install only the MDS server product, the multi-domain server product. As mentioned before, a separate multi-domain log server is not always required, so here we will leave it out in this example. So here we install an MDS server only. We then need to create the DMS servers, the domain management servers, one for each domain that they manage. Each domain management server is like an SMS, a security management server. So each DMS will also be a log server for the customer's environment. And so if we have three customers and we only have one MDS server, we need to create three DMSs, three domain management servers, one domain management server for each domain, one for each customer. And since we only have one appliance, remember, we only installed the MDS server on this appliance, each DMS, each domain management server, will also be a log server for each corresponding domain. And so domain X manages domain X gateways. And domain X gateways will send the logs to the DMS X log server running on the same MDS multi-domain server. And so each DMS, domain management server, is an SMS, a security management server. And it's also a log server, and so each DMS management server will store only its logs for its own domains on its own DMS, domain management server container. These logs will be stored separately from any other DMS logs and from any other domain management servers. And so if domain Y will be managed by DMS Y, domain Y security gateways will send logs from domain Y's environment to the MDS server, to the DMS Y server, the DMS Y log server. I hope that's starting to make sense now. Let's do another example. Scenario number two. Now let's say that we now have a bigger customer, a large service provider, that perhaps, let's say, has a large customer environment. And so to free up some of the resources on the MDS server, we want to separate the logs and store them on the separate and dedicated log server. And so in this scenario, we need to have two appliances. On one appliance, you will install the MDS, the multi-domain management server, with multiple DMSs, domain management server for each domain. And then on a second appliance, we install the MDLS server, the multi-domain log server. And here, we also need to create separate DLSs, domain log servers, one for each domain. And so now, each domain is being managed by the DMS on the MDS server, and each domain gateways will be sending logs to a separate DLS server on the MDLS server. Are you starting to get the picture now? Okay, one more scenario. Scenario number three. Here we have, for lack of a better word, a hybrid scenario. We still have two appliances. We have one MDS and one multi-domain log server. And we also have three domains, domain X, domain Y, and domain Z. On the MDS server, we have three DMSs, domain management servers, domain management server X, domain management server Y, and domain management server Z. And we also have an MDLS server, the multi-domain log server. But here, we create only two domain log servers on the MDLS server. Let's say we have DLSX and DLSY only. For whatever reason, customer Z did not want to purchase and pay to have a separate container on the MDLS server. Maybe to save cost or to fit within their budget. And so they opted out to have a dedicated DLS server on the MDLS server. And there could be other business reasons for doing this. It could be performance related, or maybe the amount of logging is not substantial, or maybe the size of the customer. The point here is that domain Z still needs to store logs. And so the logs could still be stored on that DMS Z, the domain management server on the MDS server. And so domain X will send the logs to the DLSX on the MDLS server, the multi-domain log server. And domain Y will also send its logs to the DLSY on the multi-domain log server. And so for whatever reason, domain Z will continue to send its logs to the DMS Z on the MDS server. The important thing to note here is that logs from any domain can continue to be sent to the DMS on the MDS server, as in this scenario, or the logs can be sent to a separate log server, the domain log server running on the MDLS server. And now for my final thoughts. There could be multiple other deployment scenarios in deploying multi-domain security management server, like in a high availability mode scenario, or another redundant logging solutions. But we won't get to that here in this video. I just wanted to give you a general overview of the multi-domain security management server products and some of their deployment options. And so in summary, to wrap this up, in this lesson, we mentioned that MDSM is a brand name, the Checkpoint Multi-Domain Security Management Solution. This product is used for large enterprises, customers, and service providers to manage their security real estate. And when we install MDSM software on the appliance, we have two types of products, the MDS that houses the DMSs, and the MDLS that houses the DLSs. DMS is the domain management server component of the multi-domain server. And the DLS is a log management server component of the multi-domain log server. And we also mentioned that some customers can have only one appliance, in which case they install only the MDS server, and each DMS will also capture the logs for its appropriate domain. And also, on the other hand, we have multiple customers that have the need to use two appliances, in which case then, one appliance, we install the MDS server product, and create a DMS domain management server to manage each respective domain. And then on a second appliance, we install the MDLS multi-domain log server, and here we create the DLSs, the domain log servers, to store the logs for each separate domains. Thank you again for watching. We'll see you in the next video.